coming under the purview of Department of Public Enterprises. So the act has been legislated by Ministry of Corporate Affairs and 2014, and subsequently DPE has gone, DPE has also given the guidelines regarding the implementation pattern, how this has to be brought into the real life context. So what is the strategic regulation that has been brought in since 2014? Then what is the further direction, how Niti Aayog has been involved, and how DPE is coming up with various guidelines, and what is the way forward? Quickly we will go through this. And these are the Sustainable Development Goals 17 which we are talking of. We can relate every item in the Schedule 7 of Companies Act directly to this 17 SDG goals mentioned here. Next slide. Go forward. We are talking of the triple bottom line, that is economy, society and environmental concerns woven around each other is the best possible matrix, and therefore it has been a model which has been hired from Western concept but interwoven to Indian context. This in 2014 Companies Act came up with these directives and giving the enabling law provisions, and DPE has subsequently in October 14 has come up with DPE guidelines. Can you go forward? And then sustainable development is slightly different from CSR. CSR is on the predetermined profitable quotient of preceding 3 years, but sustainable development is somewhat looks into the beyond future generations also. We have to create models which not only takes care of current generation's needs, but they also takes care of the future generation needs. So go forward quickly. So apart from this, the in my view, if I talk from public sector point of view, there is a tremendous amount of legislation created. Niti Aayog has come up with various guidelines and it is working on various projects, which to be noted among these aspirational district project which has come up in the Prime Minister's conclave in 2019, wherein 117 districts, backward districts, have been identified for investment in health, nutrition and education sectors where the country is lagging behind so much. Further, Apprentice Act has been brought into the context of CSR purview. Every organization, as per the SEBI guidelines, all the 500 listed organizations have to file business responsibility report annually in their annual statements, file for audit. And in section B of business responsibility report, it is talking in the context of how much CSR spend and sustainable development expenditure has been made, and whether the benefits to the employees and all the stakeholders, suppliers, vendors, people, employees, all the stakeholders involved, directors, financial institutions, government stakeholders, whether all have been taken care or not. And more importantly, whether the target group in which the benefits are perceived to be percolated in the context of health, nutrition and education sectors, because the Niti Aayog is measuring the overall development index in the context of the health requirements, malnutrition, the consolidation required in development of health sector, wellness centers, and then there are 5-6 parameters on which Niti Aayog has been determining the overall development index. And then 117 districts have been identified in India as most backward, and the focus is on this, and accordingly DPE has given guidelines to expend 60% of the annual CSR budget outlay necessarily in these three segments which contribute to the primarily to the sustainable development goals and the national voluntary goals, which is part of the business responsibility report. So apart from this, there is other consolidation being made. The skill development sector is being given special emphasis. The incubation research has been given special focus. The government is focusing now on creating incubation, Atal incubation mission has started, and many premier institutions like this have started incubation research for which funding can be done under CSR by public sectors and corporate sector. And then there are lots of regulatory framework which is already in place. It's only a matter of how the corporate entities, whether it is public sector unit or it is a corporate establishment, how do they take forward in a constructive, deliverable manner where the benefits are ultimately reaching the targeted and needy backward segment, underprivileged sectors in the country, whether it is urban poor or it is in the rural backward areas or the tribal area. For secondly, there are certain questions and challenges whether the tax exemptions are applicable or not to the CSR expenditure. Similarly, lots of challenges are there in this sector, but despite which the idea is that there is already a regulatory framework which is created emulating the model given by UN development. It's only a matter of how the public establishments and corporates take it forward in a constructive way where the deliverables are in a measurable form and it benefits the ultimate beneficiaries. Just I'll take two more minutes. I want to show the other slides. Yeah, close this and then. Fine, I just wanted to show you what is the dispensation of Schedule 7 which can be correlated with SDGs, and then what is the public sector consolidation that has taken place so far. Around the current dispensation of Department of Public Enterprise is 60% of your annual budget you have to expend in the items listed under Schedule 7 necessarily. Apart from that, Skill Development, Apprentice Promotion Act, everything has been brought into the purview of CSR, where beyond the mandatory 2.5% after meeting the mandatory obligation of 2.5% apprentices, beyond that you can put CSR funds for apprentice development. Skill development, sector skill councils have been brought in various segments, apparel sector skill councils, gem and jewelry sector skill councils. They have been brought it is an incubated projects out of NSDC. So in my view, there is a tremendous consolidation happening in India, but it's a matter of time before how the public establishments, there is a slight difference between public corporates and private corporate entities. If you look at top 100 performing organizations in this country, top 10 are belonging to mostly the private sector, Tata's, Reliance, Infosys, Wipro and all this, most of the Tata Group companies. Now excepting BPCL or one Maharatna PSU, the consolidation is not to that extent. For implementing, at least emulating the model of developed economies in the context of gender equality or backwardness, whatever it is, uplifting the underprivileged segment, if the development fund required at the national level is 5 lakh crores annually, the quotient of CSR investment is just a matter of 10,000 crores, and that too among PSUs it is 4,000 crores on an average. So look at that. If the for implementing this SDGs in a real context in a country size of 130 crores population, it is extraordinary a task before the government, before the all the stakeholders. And therefore, if the requirement is of football size, The consolidation through CSR and sustainable development measures in this country are of a mustard seed size. So this is the comparison. So with this, I thank this also and all my co-panelists for giving me this opportunity. I'm open for any questions on this. Thank you. In fact, I couldn't present all my presentation. Maybe some next time. Yes. Thank you.
We'll have second round of questions.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thanks for the comments by the several panelists. They've actually covered a lot of points, which sets the context in what I was about to say. Jamshedji Tata, who founded the Tata Group, he said that in a free enterprise, community is not just another stakeholder, but in fact is the very purpose of its existence. And the Tata Group has embodied this philosophy over the 150 years of its existence. The Tata Group, I'm not sure how many of us here are aware of it, but has a very unique structure which lends itself to work continuously for the community. Tata Sons, which is the holding company of the Tata Group, meaning Tata Sons owns shares major stakes in the different Tata Group companies, at some point there were about 100 companies. The Tata Trusts,